go into lockdown for about 15 minutes.
When it happened, I was like in the bathroom and I just came out. I heard the announcement. I thought it was just a drill. And then he said, this is not a drill. I was like, okay. So I just see everyone running. I'm like, let me just go with them and go in the room. I'm like, I still don't know what's going on at that point.
Well, you hear all the things happening on the news and it's kind of scary. You know, there's something could happen. It's scary.
And again, as Ben mentioned, state police described that man who entered the garage as emotionally disturbed. They say he's 40 years old, and he's now been taken to the hospital for an evaluation. We're live in Boston. John Atwater, WCVB News Center 5.
John, thank you. We have some breaking medical news tonight. A new study released just about 15 minutes ago now provides new hope for one of the deadliest and most aggressive forms of cancer.
Jessica Brown back in the newsroom with the results. Jessica, one of the doctors involved calling the results unprecedented.
Yeah, that's right. In fact, the team at Mass General Cancer Center said the treatment's impact on glioblastoma tumors was unlike anything they've ever seen with other therapies. Well, this treatment is a new kind of what's known as CAR T cell therapy, an approach that arms the body's own T cells to fight the patient's cancer. That's already standard care for many cancers, but this therapy adds another level. It adds specially engineered T cells injected directly into the fluid around the brain, which enlist other cells around them to target and kill the tumor. Well, Dr. Marcella Moss, whose MGH lab developed the treatment, says those T cells are a critical weapon.
Some of the things they can do is when they recognize a target, and they can do that very specifically, they kill it. And so that makes it a very powerful kind of platform to build on to redirect it towards a cancer.
Well, Dr. Moss and MGH neurosurgeon Brian Choi say the early results from this clinical trial have been remarkable. You're looking at the before and after images of one of the patient's brains here. So 5 days after just one injection, the tumor had shrunk dramatically. Now, I should point out, this is really a preliminary, it's really early trial, just 3 patients, and really to test the safety of the procedure. More research is needed here, but doctors at MGH Cancer Center say it really does provide a lot of hope.